Today's topic is unit number 1. In unit number 1, we will do summary of reading selection 1.1. 1.1 is the farewell sermon. Today we will do summary of the farewell sermon and book exercise page from 8 to 10, second year subject English. Summary of the farewell sermon. The farewell sermon was delivered by our Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam to a gathering of over 120,000 at the end of performing his first and last pilgrimage. So the farewell sermon was delivered. Farewell sermon means alvidai khutba. Rasul Pak sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam ne takriban 120,000 ke गैदरिंग लोगों जमा थे उनको ये खुतबा दिया एट द एंड ऑफ परफॉर्मिंग हिज फर्स्ट एंड लास्ट पिलग्रिमेज जब वो अपना पहला और आखिरी हज अदा कर रहे थे. द सर्मन वॉज डिलीवर्ड ऑन 9 ज़ुल्हिज्जा 10th AH 632 AD. इट वॉज डिलीवर्ड इन द यूराना वैली ऑफ माउंट अरफात इन मक्का while sitting on the back of his camel. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam delivered this sermon in Yurana Valley. Where is Yurana Valley? It is in Mount Arafat. In Mount Arafat there was Yurana Valley in Makkah. So he delivered this sermon in Yurana Valley while sitting on the back of his camel. As the voice of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam was low, he asked Rabba ibn Umayya ibn Khalaf to repeat the sermon sentence by sentence after him so that it could reach out to everyone in the valley. In this sermon, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave the world the character of fundamental human rights which has been adopted. In this sermon, इस खुतबे में the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam gave the world दुनिया को दिया the character of fundamental human rights इंसानी बुनियादी हकूक के किरदार के बारे में बताया which has been adopted जिसको इख्तियार कर सकते हैं by all the nations of the world today जिसको आज तक के लोग इख्तियार कर सकते हैं. In this last sermon, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam directed the Muslims to regard the property and life of one and other as sacred as the month of Zulhijjah. In the last sermon, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam directed means instructed, hidayat di, the Muslims to regard means respect the property and life of one another as sacred इस तरह एहतराम करें जैसे कि इस मुकद्दस महीने की sacred as the month of Zulhijjah. He advised the people to return the goods entrusted to them and never hurt anybody. He advised the people to return the goods. Goods means ashya, entrusted जो अमानत रखी गई हैं उनके पास to them. So return all the entrusted goods to the owner of the goods and never hurt anybody. He further told them that usury was forbidden. Usury means sood was forbidden and that they had to be aware of the tricks of Satan. Satan means shaitan aur unko shaitan ki tricks means jalsazi se dur rehna hoga. He clarified that wives and husbands had to abide by the laws of Allah ke biwiyon aur shohron ko Allah ke huqooq ki ataat karni hogi. Abide means ataat karna in their dealings with each other jab wo ek dusre ke sath mamlaat kare जब वो एक दूसरे के साथ सलूक करें जब वो एक दूसरे के साथ हुस्ने सलूक से रहें तो उन्हें अल्लाह के अतात मानने होंगे अल्लाह की कानून की अतात करनी होगी द लॉज ऑफ अल्लाह अल्लाह के कानून की अतात करनी होगी. द हस्बैंड शुड ट्रीट देयर वाइव्स विद काइंडनेस एंड केयर. In the farewell sermon, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told the people that all the Muslims of the world constituted one brotherhood. All the Muslims of the world, tamam duniya ke musalman constituted, tashkeel dete hain one brotherhood, bhai chara. Duniya mein jitne musalman hain, wo ek bhai chara banate hain, wo tamam log ek dusre ke bhai hain. They were equal in the eyes of God. He announced that an Arab had no superiority over a non-Arab, nor a non-Arab had any superiority over an Arab. The best of them was the one who feared God. In mein se behtareen wo hai jise Allah ka khauf hai. The standard of superiority is in the eyes of God was based on character. Allah ki nazar mein bartari kirdar par mabni hai, rather than on caste, color or nationality. Na ke wo caste, zaat, rang ya qaumiyat par mabni ho. In the end, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam directed the people to convey his message to those who were not present on the occasion. So he instructed the present people to convey his message to those who were not present on the occasion, jo is mauke par maujood nahi hain, un tak ye baatein pahuncha di jaye. So it was the summary of the lesson, the farewell sermon. Now coming to book exercise. In book exercise, we will revise parts of speech. I hope you have learned parts of speech in your previous classes, but I'll revise it for you. Parts of speech. Words are divided into different kinds or classes called parts of speech according to their use, that is according to the work they do in a sentence. The parts of speech are 8 in number: noun, adjective, pronoun, verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction, interjection. First one is noun. A noun is a word used as the name of person, place or thing as. Examples are: Akbar was a great king. Lahore is on the Ravi. The rose smells sweet. The sun shines brightly. His courage won him honor. The word things include: number one, all objects that we can see, hear, taste, touch or smell. So if we say that a noun is a word used as the name of person, place or thing, so over here we are defining things. Which things are noun? So the word things includes all objects that we can see, hear, taste, touch or smell. And number two, something that we can think of, jiske baare mein hum soch sakte hain, but cannot perceive the sense, but cannot feel the sense. Something that we can only think, but cannot feel the sense. So these are the things in noun. Now coming to the second one, an adjective. An adjective is a word used to add something to the meaning of a noun as: he is a brave boy. Brave, it is adjective. There are 20 boys in this class. Number three, a pronoun. A pronoun is a word used instead of a noun as: Aslam is absent because he is ill. So we use Aslam as noun and then we use its pronoun he. The books are where you left them. Number four, a verb. A verb is a word used to say something about some person or things as: the girl wrote a letter to her cousin. Wrote, it is verb. Verb is action word. Peshawar is a big town. Iron and copper are useful metals. An adverb is a word used to add something to the meaning of verb, an adjective or another adverb as: he worked the sum quickly.
This flower is very beautiful. She pronounced the word quite correctly. Quickly, beautiful, correctly. These are adverbs. A preposition is word used with a noun or pronoun to show the person or thing denoted by noun or pronoun stands in relation to something else as. There is a cow in the garden. In is preposition. The girl is fond of music. A fair little girl sat under a tree. Under is a preposition. Number 7 is a conjunction is a word used to join words or sentences as. Javed and Javeria are cousins. And is conjunction. 2 and 2 make 4. I ran fast but missed the train. And but it is conjunction. An interjection is word which expresses some sudden feelings. Hurrah! We have won the game. Alas, she is dead. As words are divided into different classes according to the work in sentences, it is clear that we cannot say to which part of speech a word belongs unless we see it used in a sentence. Number 1. They arrived soon after. So, in this sentence, after is used as an adverb. It is telling us about a verb. They arrived. When arrived? Soon after. They arrived after us. They arrived after us. It is a preposition. So, it is a relation between one noun to another or one pronoun to another. So, the word after is used over here in a form of preposition. They arrived after we had left. Conjunction, joining two sentences or two letters. They arrived, we had left. So, they arrived after we had left. So, after is used over here in a form of conjunction. From the above example, we see that the same word can be used as different parts of speech. Now coming to book exercise. Name the part of speech of each italicized word in the following sentences, giving each case your reason for the classification. Italicized. What is italicized word? Italicized word which are written in a particular way. Italicized means printed using the style in which the words are leaning forward. So it is the writing style, it is a printing style which is termed as italicized. So all the words which are written differently, these are termed as italicized. So the name the part of speech of each italicized word, you have to name the italicized word and then you have to give the reason. Still waters run deep. Still waters run deep. Still is adjective over here. It is telling us about noun, water. It is telling us about water. So still waters run deep. It is, still is adjective. You have to write, I am dictating you, and you have to write it on your book. Still is adjective. Second one is, he still lives in the house. He still lives in the house. It is telling about the noun. Who is living in the house? He still lives in the house. So he still is qualifying noun. So it is adjective. Still is adjective. Number 3. After the storm comes the calm. Jab after the storm, jab tufan sukoon se ho gaya, jab tufan tham gaya, ruk gaya. So after is preposition over here. It is telling the relation of one noun with another. So it is preposition. Number 4. The after effects of the drug are bad. It is adjective. After is adjective. It is telling about the noun drug, the after effect of the drug.
So after over here is adjective. It is telling us about noun. Number 5. The up train is late. Up train, so it is telling us about noun. Up is adjective. Up is adjective. Number 6. It weighs about a pound. It weighs about a pound. About is adjective. It is telling about pronoun. It is telling about pronoun. So it weighs about a pound. Who weighs it? So it is used. It is qualifying pronoun. So about is used in this sentence as adjective. Number 7. He told us all about the battle. All about the battle. About is preposition. He told us all about the battle. So in sentence number 7, about is used as preposition. It is telling us about the relationship of nouns. He was only a yard off me. He was only. Only is adjective. It is qualifying noun. He is only is qualifying he. So it is adjective. A yard off me. Off is preposition. Number 9. Suddenly one of the wheels came off. Suddenly one of the wheels came off. Off is adverb. Adverb. It is telling us about verb. Came off. So came means bahir ajana. Came is an action word and off is used after it. So it is adverb. Off is adverb in this sentence. Mohammedans fast in the month of Ramzan. Fast in this sentence is used as noun. It is the naming word of a thing. It is used in this sentence as a noun. 11. He kept the fast for a week. He kept the fast for a week. Fast over here is verb. He kept the fast. Fast is an action word. There is action in this word. So fast over here is used as verb. He is on the committee. On is used as preposition. Let us move on. Move on. Move is verb. On. Move on. So it is on over here is used as verb. Move on. Sit down and rest a while. Rest a while. So rest means an action word. So rest a while, it is adverb. I will watch while you sleep. So it is conjunction. Conjunction is used to join two words or sentences together. So I will watch you sleep. These are two sentences and it is joined by using while. While is conjunction over here. 16. They while away their evenings with books and games. While away, guzarna. So while away, it is a verb. While away, guzarna. It is an action verb. So while away over here is used as verb. Activity. Your activity is learn summary of lesson, the farewell sermon. Thank you.